Hi, glory to God. Have you ever asked yourself, am I supposed to make my day great? You know what? This is Pastor Peter this morning bringing God's word to you, and I'll be showing you how to make your day great. Glory to God. This morning, I'll be showing you a scripture from the book of Hebrews. Yes, Hebrews chapter number 6, verse number 12. Yes, and this scripture reads, actually, it reads, that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promise. That ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promise. So the scriptures let us know the very essence of, you know, following those who have obtained the promises of God, those who are ahead of us by in the walk of faith, the fathers of the faith. You know, the word of God tells us in Hebrews 11 verse 1 to 3, you find the scriptures talked about that by faith the elders obtained a good report. So the word of God is inspiring us this morning as we woke up and as you're getting set for your day. You should be able to, you know, look into God's word and find those who, though they went through diverse trials, temptations, though they had challenges, but because they were able to switch on their faith, they were able to tune on their faith, they had victories. And the Lord is giving us admonition this morning that as we go out, that this should be our guide. This should be that which tells us up. This should be the shiny examples that we see. Yes, we should be able to see men like Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We should be able to see the faith that Moses demonstrated. How through faith and patience they obtained the promise. How the prophet of old, though many of them were persecuted, tried, and they had several, you know, challenges that confronted them, but yet they had victories. How? Because they, through faith and patience, they obtained the promise. Look at the life of a man like David, who from his childhood, he had so many challenges. From the age of about a toddler, he was actually, he was not even up to 18. He had to confront a giant called Goliath. And because of his faith in the Lord, because of his trust and confidence in the Lord, he brought down this giant who was a pain to the in the neck of Israel. Yet David stepped right in. Yes, he stepped right in where the all men, the military warriors and the warlords in the Israeli army were drawing back and full of fear. Even the king Saul was, you know, taken over by fear because of the boast of this giant called Goliath. They were all taken by fear. They were petrified. But you know what? David, because of his experience with God, because of his one-on-one fellowship with God, he had come to know the presence of God and the power of God. He had come to understand what God's word can do when you put it in your heart and in your mouth, how that it can stir up faith in you, and how the word can give you victory at every count. So David, he put the word of God to work. Yes, he put the word of God to work. And you know what? Through faith and patience, he obtained the promise. Yes, the life of David is full of so many shining examples and incidents and situations where to the natural man, it was like all done. It was like nothing good was going to come out. But David trusted the Lord. Trusted the Lord, and the Lord gave him victory. You know what? That's the way to go today. You know, there are many people who talk about the fact that it's very good to be original. How that you don't need to copy others. You know, why they may have a point, but you know what? Life is actually full of copying. Life is actually full of imitation. Yes, most people who ever make headway in life, they at one time or the other were imitators. Actually, when we are born, from the moment we are born and when we started getting raised by our parents, All we did was to imitate. Just imagine that little baby who was born. A human being, of course he was. He had all the potentials. The legs were there. The hands were there. He had a tongue. Yes, he could form words. But yet, all that we are not in full use yet the moment he was born or she was born. All that they needed, that little child needed to do is to be trained. Yes, he began to learn how to walk. He sees his parents walking. He sees those around him walking. And you know what? He began to train how to put those legs on the ground. Sometimes he falls, but then he stands up again. He tries to take that step. Yeah, he's doing it just because he saw others doing it. If he had not seen any other person doing it, he might not have thought of walking. And you know what? Others encouraging that child, and he began to train those feet to learn how to walk. Yes, and very soon he begins to imitate them, and he runs very soon. Why? He's imitating others. When he forms words, yes, the initial words are not, you know, they are not, you can't understand exactly what the child says. It's like child babbling. Yeah, but gradually, with him seeing and hearing those around him speaking and talking to him, calling their names, they begin to form those words right. Yes, they begin to imitate others. They begin to learn how to say Baba. They begin to learn how to say Mama. Why? They are imitating others. So the question is not about not imitating people, because we all imitate in life. We all do one form of imitation or the other. Even those who talk about not imitating, oftentimes they say so because they heard somebody saying so. So they start imitating the person who told them not to imitate, or who taught them that imitation is not good. They start imitating those ideas that they heard somebody teaching them, and they imitate those thoughts, and you know, they say it. So life is full of basically imitation. So the question is not about whether you imitate or not, because everybody basically imitates at one point in time or the other. But the issue is, who are you imitating? That's the question. Who are you imitating, or what are you imitating? Because we must all imitate. So the question is, imitate that which is right. Imitate that which will make you make progress in life. Imitate that which will help you attain the whole full potentials that the Lord has bestowed in your life. Imitate that which will help you become all that God has called you to be. And that's what the Word of God is admonishing us this morning as you go out, as you set out for your day. He said that we should not be slothful. Yes, but that we should be what? Followers. Hallelujah. In other words, imitators. When you say followers, it means imitators. We follow the examples of others, and not just any person on the street, not just any, you know, a music star, like some people, you know, look around and they say this man is a star, the other man is a star. And when you find out what those stars have done in life, it's shameful. Many of those things they get involved in are shameful, and we are not supposed to let such stars be our example. But rather, we should look out for heroes of faith. Yes, heroes of faith, men who lived many years before us in scriptures, and many who are still alive right now, who are walking the paths of righteousness and putting the word of God to work and getting results. These should be our stars. Hallelujah. These men and women of faith should be those who give us example. They should be those who we follow. Hallelujah. When many people on social media, they say, I follow this man, I follow the other lady. You know what? You follow that which is of God. That man or that woman who inspires you with God's word daily. Hallelujah. So you begin to set them out wherever they are. Whether they are in the scriptures, you set them out. You study their life and their examples. Hallelujah. Whether they are living, yes, even maybe they are contemporaries with you, you study them, you study their ministries, you study their life, you study their principles, you study what they believe in, the faith, how they put God's word to work. You study it, you put it to work in your life. Hallelujah. That's the way to go. Hallelujah. And before you know it, not too long, like that little child who had to study and imitate the parents, Not too long, you too will be walking. Not too long, you too will be running with those principles that will make your day great, that will make your life great, that you make a bright future for you. Exactly. That's the way to go in this month of victory on every side. That's the way to go. Yes, the scripture declares, it said, we should not be slothful. Hallelujah. Because the Lord does not encourage slothfulness. He does not encourage us to be lazy. He does not encourage us to be physically or even mentally lazy, but to put to work all the abilities that he has given us. Yes, because as new creation in Christ Jesus, we've been endowed with so much abilities of the spirit, and abilities also even in the natural. So we don't let them go to waste. Hallelujah. It's like the parable of the talent that Jesus talked about, when he talked about a master who was going on a journey, and he gave three of his servants, he gave them talent. He gave them monies. That's what it basically means. He invested in them. He gave them monies to invest. He gave one 5 talents. He gave another one 2 talents. And he gave another one 1 talent. The one with 5 talents invested it and got profit. The one with 2 talents invested it and reproduced those 2 talents and got profit 2 more. And the one with 1 talent would not invest it. He dug the ground and placed it in there. And when the master came back and was asking them for, you know, to give account of their stewardship, they all brought theirs out. And the master praised the one with 5 for having more 5 in profit, the one with 2 for adding more 2 in profit. But the one who was given 1 brought just the 1 talent that he was given. And the master said, thou wicked servant. He said, for the servant that said, I know you, master, that you always want to get where you did not sow. In other words, the servant understood that the master liked profit, and now he was trying to tease the master with his love for profit. And the master told him, so you know I love profit. He said, then you should have kept this talent in a bank so that it will yield interest, so that at my coming I will have it with interest. And you know what? He called that servant, you wicked servant. And he said they should cast him into outer darkness. And you know what? That tells the purpose of God for every one of us. The Lord does not want you to remain in the same level that you've always been. The Lord encourages and wants us to be, you know, out there, put into use the abilities of the spirit that he's giving us. He wants us to grow. He wants us to make progress. Hallelujah. And that's God's intention for you today. As you go out, progress. That's what God wants for you. Progress on every side. He wants you to have victories on every side. Victory in your job, victory in your health, victory in your business, victory in your family, victory in all that you lay your hands to do in your academic. He wants you to excel. Yes, that's God's plan and purpose for you. He don't want you to be a sluggard. He don't want you to be sluggish. He don't want you to be slothful, but to be followers, but to be a follower, to be an imitator of they who through faith and patient men and women of faith, who through faith and patience they put into work, they put into use, they put into operation the abilities of God in their life, and they got results. And these are the people that you should follow. Hallelujah. He said we should be followers of such. We should be imitators of such, who through faith and patience obtain the promise. Hallelujah. Because the Lord intends for you that you should dwell, you should live, you should, you know, see the promise as a reality in your life. The promises of God are not just promises for the future, but the promises of God are for the here and now. The Lord expects you to enjoy the promise. It should be a present hour reality. Hallelujah. For scripture says the promises of God in Christ Jesus, they are yea and amen. Hallelujah. So it's the will of God that you begin to experience every word that the Lord has given in scriptures concerning your head. That when he spoke and said head, when he declares that your body is a temple of the Holy Ghost, for instance, yes, it shows that your body is not supposed to be indwelled by sickness or disease or infirmity. The scripture tells us, he said, Healing is the bread of his children. For by his stripes you were healed. Not that you're going to be healed. He said you were healed. Yes, by the stripes you received. These are no more promises. This should be reality for the new creation. This should be your daily reality. Hallelujah. And the Lord expects you to, you know, learn to follow men and women who through patience, faith and patience have been living in this reality. Hallelujah. So that if sickness and disease have been plaguing you in recent time, you begin to search out scriptures. You begin to look out for the teachings and, you know, for the inspiration given by men and women of faith who through faith and patience have been living and dwelling and enjoying divine health. Hallelujah. When maybe you're thinking about your finances, the same principles apply. The scripture declares, it's a wealth and riches are in the house of the righteous. So you as a child of God who is born again, you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, wealth and riches are supposed to be in your house. This should be your reality. So as you go out today, let this inspire you. Hallelujah. You keep declaring God's word to yourself. You keep announcing God's word to yourself. You keep saying it. You don't get tired about declaring the word. And you know what? You see the word of God reproduce what it talks about in your life. For you is not yet born again. Maybe you've not yet known Jesus as the Lord of your life, and you've not yet confessed him as the Lord of your life. You know what? That's what to do right now. And this is the time to do so. Hallelujah. The scripture tells us in Acts of the Apostles 2 verse 21. It says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And the scripture also tells us in Romans 10 verse 8 to 10. It says, for with the heart man believes, but with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You want to make that declaration now. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus. Yes, say it after me. You say, I come to you just as I am, a sinner. I believe that you sent your son, Jesus Christ, as the perfect sacrifice for my sin, that he died, that he was buried, and on the third day, he rose again for my justification. You declare. You say, right now, I've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God. Yes, I'm no longer for the devil and his kingdom. I am a child of God. I am born again. If you made that prayer from the depth of your heart, you are born again. Welcome to the family of God. Look out for a Bible believing church in the city where you live. Join that church so that you'll be groomed up and trained in the things of God. If peradventure you live anywhere around Padova in Italy, I want to invite you specially to be a guest at Healing Grace Christian Assembly, Via J Avanso number 17, just behind the Padova train station. Yes, as soon as you come out from the underground subway in the Padova train station in the Acela direction, you find a building where you have the Polizia Locale. Just beside the Polizia Locale, you find a yellow doorpost. That's the entrance to our church. You walk right up to the first floor and you find us there. On Sundays, we are there. By 10 o'clock, the Sunday school begins. And by 11 o'clock, the main service. And on Tuesdays, we are there by 6:30 to 8 p.m. where we agree with you for prayers in our prayer meetings for a miracle for you. And you know what? We'll be expecting you with open hands. Ensure to share this message with at least 10 persons in your contact, your friends, your relatives, your families. You share to them so that you inspire them to start up with a great day. Exactly. And if you have not subscribed on our YouTube channel, ensure to do so now. And the name is Peter Ashazobo, or Pastor Peter Ashazobo on YouTube. Tune on the notification bell so that when next we post new audios or video messages, you'll be among the first to receive it. Yeah. So as you share the message, God bless you and do it now. God bless you, and I want to wish you have a great day. God bless you.